The French Air Force's 6th Gen fighter jet just shocked the USAF. The Tempest project is developing the next generation of fighters in Britain. Theoretical ideas being investigated include mind-reading aircraft and extremely sophisticated artificial intelligence. What will a fighter jet of the 6th generation look like? And what kind of technology will be employed on a plane that won't be flying for another 15 years? Well, let's find out. Hey guys, welcome to our channel, Future Warplanes, where we tell you about military fighter jets, military drones, and military planes from the currently famous in the air to the most advanced around the world. So stay with us till the end of this video so you don't miss out on any of this information. And before we proceed, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon so you don't miss out on any of our amazing videos in the future. And let's get started. The UK Royal Air Force, or RAF, is developing the Tempest, a 6th-generation combat aircraft as part of the Future Combat Air System program to enhance the country's air combat capabilities to counter new threats. Team Tempest, a project led by the UK-based aerospace corporation BAE Systems, is creating the aircraft. The collaboration also includes business associates such as the Italian aerospace corporation Leonardo, MDBA UK, a unit of MBDA UK, manufacturer of European missile systems, and Rolls-Royce. To create the next fighter plane, a team collaborates with the RAF and the UK Ministry of Defense. The Tempest FCAS prototype plane is being developed at a BAE system site close to Preston in northern England, and it should be unveiled by 2027. A component of the UK's combat air strategy, which was unveiled in July 2018, is the Tempest FCAS aircraft. In the same month, the Tempest aircraft idea was shown at the Farnborough Air Show. The concept and evaluation phase of the project will commence on July 2021 after BAE Systems was awarded a contract by the Ministry of Defense for the design and development of the Tempest FCAS aircraft in the amount of roughly $347 million. By 2025, the UK government's anticipated to contribute more than $2.4 billion to the project. By 2035, the British RAF is anticipated to start using the Tempest FCAS aircraft. The Tempest program collaborations. In July 2019, Sweden and the UK collaborated on the FCAS initiative for the cooperative development of future fighter jet capabilities and systems. The nations also emphasized the agreement as a chance to update its JAS-39 Gripen and Typhoon combat aircraft systems with cutting-edge technologies. During the Defense and Security Equipment International, or DSEI, convention in London in September 2019, business partners from the UK and Italy signed a statement of intent for collaboration on the Tempest FCAS program. In order to harness the potential of the industries of the three countries for the creation of a future combat air capability, the UK, Italy, and Sweden started industry discussions in July 2020. In December 2020, a trilateral agreement was signed by the three nations for the development of Tempest. In December 2021, the UK and Japan formed a joint venture to create a jet engine demonstration for the next fighter program. In February 2022, the two nations committed to working together to pursue research on the creation of the Jaguar Universal Radio Frequency Sensor technology for use in fighter jets. The FCAS program's joint concept analysis in July 2022 is being worked on, according to the Ministry of Defense, in collaboration with Japan and Italy. In July 2019, Thales and Aralis, a UK-based maker of aircraft and components, worked together to create designs for a ground-based training and simulation system that would be an addition to the Tempest FCAS aircraft program. All aspects of a future flight training system are anticipated to be supported by the system. In July 2020, the Team Tempest inked agreements to collaborate on upcoming combat air concepts and related technologies with 7 businesses, including Thales UK, Bombardier Belfast, Collins Aerospace, GE Aviation UK, GKN Aerospace, Martin Baker, and Kinetic. For Tempest, Collins Aerospace will supply cutting-edge actuation technologies. Working on open architecture and infrastructure for electrical power and avionic systems is GE Aviation UK, a part of GE Aviation. Ejection seat development will be handled by Martin Baker, while test and evaluation efforts will be aided by Kinetic. In July 2020, GKN Aerospace Sweden joined industry partners in the UK and Italy in the feasibility studies in the development for future fighter engine technology. In June 2022, Saab was given a contract of $25 million by the Swedish Defense Material Administration, or FMV, to carry out research on the advancement of fighter aircraft technologies. Under the terms of a collaboration agreement with Electronica, an Italian supplier of electronic defense equipment, Leonardo is participating in the FCAS program. The partnership will concentrate on showcasing the aircraft's cutting-edge sensors and systems. Over 600 organizations in the UK are participating in the Tempest program. In April 2022, BAE Systems hired Wind River, a developer of software solutions, to assist with the Tempest program's technology demonstration effort. Tempest will be a sixth-generation, optionally manned fighter jet with stealth capabilities that is built to be flexible, networked, and upgradable to keep up with evolving threats. The design is anticipated to incorporate open architecture to allow for future capability expansion and adaptation. In order for the airplane to function at higher temperatures, sophisticated composite materials and additives will be used to create the airframe. It's being developed as a component of the larger FCAS and will use cutting-edge manufacturing techniques and digital engineering technology to speed up production. Scalable autonomy will be supported by the aircraft, enabling manned, unmanned, and optionally manned operations. Tempest will be able to support future missiles like Meteor, a next-generation beyond-visual-range air-to-air missile, as well as weapons that are already scheduled for development. Using software augmented by AI and machine learning, the Weapons Effects Management System will regulate how all weapons on the battlefield are coordinated. A defense support system equipped with the Tempest will be able to track, aim, and intercept incoming missiles. The fighter aircraft will act as a node in a network of systems that spans all domains of the battle space. In future conflicts, it will work in tandem with other FCAS systems such as unmanned combat aircraft, civil platforms, satellites, and cybersecurity centers. To provide manned-unmanned flying capabilities, the aircraft will use artificial intelligence, machine learning, and autonomous systems, and it's also expected to control drones using swarming technology. In order to provide accurate information that can be shared with other linked aircraft in a combat cloud, it'll receive data from many sources. The aircraft will be outfitted with a flexible, software-driven flight control system of the next generation. Through a connected network, its reconfigurable communication system will provide secure and seamless communication across air, sea, land, and space. The gesture control and eye tracking features in the cockpit will allow the pilot's workload to be measured and his fatigue and mental stress to be identified. Rolls-Royce created Orpheus, a new gas turbine demonstrator engine for the FCAS program. The advanced power and propulsion system of the aircraft will be aerodynamically designed to optimize overall performance, range, and payload capability. The aircraft will be outfitted with advanced sensors, allowing for the rapid, secure, and resilient exchange of information on the battlefield via combat cloud. Leonardo is developing a Tempest Integrated Sensing and Non-Kinetic Effects and Integrated Communication System, or ICS. The effectors will aid in the assessment and evaluation of incoming threats, as well as the management of the deployment of the appropriate method to defeat them. And that's it for today, guys. We sincerely hope you enjoyed our video. If you did, please click on the like button and share it with your friends and family. If you have any further questions or comments, you're always welcome to share them with us in the comment space below. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see even more of our incredible videos. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.